you've, you know, made an incredible splash over the years just looking at bias in studies and looking at bias in the way in which, you know, scientists go about their work, and they've actually thanked you for it. They haven't felt hostility towards you. What if you were to give an assessment of what biases may have been at work in pushing us towards this particular solution of general lockdown, what might your assessment be?
I think that it's still early in the course of the epidemic to make definitive conclusions about which biases were more influential. I think it would be very important once the dust has settled to try to dissect what went wrong and what was the appropriate response and try to learn from that. I believe that there is a domino effect. I think that once you believe in some exaggerated estimates and you start making decisions that may be extreme, there's a sense that if you don't follow up with even more stringent decisions and even more severe decisions, you may be claimed to be negligent. And there is a risk that even leaders who have lots of faith in their judgment, if they see that other leaders are following a specific path that is very aggressive, or conversely, is not aggressive at all, they may feel that they need to follow suit and have that domino effect. So there's bandwagon effect, there's domino effect, and in the meanwhile, most of that is happening with no evidence. There's also a lot of that media halo that is surrounding this whole adventure. If you just go to Google, I did that, and I just typed coronavirus, and you get something like 9 billion results. If you type influenza, you get something like 100 million results. So I think that we have really a pandemic of news stories and news clips and anecdotes about coronavirus. And I don't want to diminish its importance, but we need to get solid evidence along with the anecdotes at a minimum.